Hey guys, it's me again. If you don't know me, my name is Ivan. My alias is Dreamframer, and today I have a special treat for you. I have an image created by a very young and talented photographer. His name is Josiah Budding, and he posted some of his images on Reddit asking people how to improve them further. I have to say, all his images are very good straight out of the camera, so I'm not gonna do any kind of advanced retouching here. What I'm gonna do is just bringing some more light, and if I may say, a little bit more life to one of those images. And even though I'm using Photoshop CC, I'm just gonna do very basic stuff. So if you just follow me, I'm sure you can replicate the same thing in any kind of editing software that you use when you edit your pictures. So let's get to it. Okay guys, let's see what we can do with this picture. First things first, we want to duplicate the background layer because we want our original layer to stay basically intact. I'm gonna do that by dragging the background layer onto the new layer icon down here. I'm gonna call this layer just layer 1. Now I'm gonna straighten the horizon by going to these three dots here. When I click on them, the ruler tool is gonna show up, and that's because I already used this tool before. But if you didn't, you can just click and hold your mouse and the new set of tools will open up. One of them is ruler tool. So I'm just dragging from one to the other side of the water with my mouse, and I'm gonna click straighten layer now. Okay. Now when I did this, I want to crop the image the way I want it to look like in the end. So with selection tool selected, I'm gonna drag with my mouse and try to imagine how the final image will look like. Something like that, okay. I'm gonna go to the image menu and click crop. When I turn off the background layer, you're gonna see that we have some transparent areas around the edges, and that's because we rotated the picture a little bit. So these are the areas, one here and probably one in the upper right corner. So I'm gonna fix that right away with a patch tool. With patch tool selected, I'm gonna paint over these areas. I'm sorry that you can't see the patch tool selected, you just see the arrow, the regular arrow, and that's because the software that I'm using to record the screen doesn't show these custom cursors from Photoshop, so I have to change the software, I guess. This is now the composition that I like more than the original picture from the camera. Now I want to duplicate this layer because I want to play with one of the copies, and I'm gonna do that by dragging this layer down to the new layer icon, and I'm gonna rename this layer to Camera Raw, and that's because I want to import this layer in the filter called Camera Raw. So with the layer selected, I'm going to filter menu over here and I will select Camera Raw filter. Now our layer is imported into Camera Raw software, and I'm in the basic panel over here. I'm just gonna click auto button to see what Camera Raw is gonna do with the picture, and as you can see, the picture is already lighting up a little bit, especially shadows, and I like how it looks like. Unfortunately, this is just a JPEG version of the picture, so I can't do much about the clouds, and I would really like them to pop up more, which would be really easy to do by dragging this clarity slider. However, I have to be careful because this slider can really mess up her skin tone. Just watch her face while I'm dragging this slider all the way up. I don't want that. So even though I'm gonna change her skin tone a little bit, I can fix that later if necessary, but this will bring these clouds a little bit more in front. I'm gonna add a little bit of vibrance and just a little bit of saturation, because saturation can be really a dangerous lighter. You don't want to add too much of it. This way I added more light to the picture. And now I'm just gonna go to this tab over here and saturate a little bit more some of the tones, like aquas and yellow tones, maybe orange a little bit, so the sky becomes a little bit warmer. And maybe I can try with green too, just to bring these bushes up a little bit to make them more green. Now I'm going to the sharpening and noise reduction tab, and while using zoom tool, I'm gonna zoom to her face and see if there is any noise over there. And as you can see, there is a lot of noise. So I'm gonna reduce that by dragging up this luminance slider. That's about it. And maybe a little bit of color noise as well. That's much better. Now with a picture like this, I'm just gonna click OK, and that's gonna bring us back to Photoshop. And you can easily see how this new layer now has more light and, let's say, a little bit more life to it. When I turn it off and on, you can see the difference. I'm just gonna do a couple of little touch-ups before I continue. I noticed a couple of objects that bother me a little bit, and two of those are these two sensor spots. I don't know if you can see them on your monitor, but they look like grayish round spots, and I'm gonna fix that with a patch tool. They're really not a big problem, it's just me, I guess. Again, I'm sorry that you can't see the tool that is active, you just see this arrow, and that's because of the software that I'm using to record the screen. So now I'm gonna go to the patch tool and delete these two sensor spots by painting over them. Okay, that's better. Zooming out a little bit, and I'm gonna move to the object that I see on the water, and I don't really know what it is. Maybe it's a physical object, maybe it's another sensor spot, but I'm gonna delete it because I don't need it. Okay, that's about it. I also noticed a little red patch on her face, and that doesn't look like something permanent. And it's not like I really have to remove that, but since I'm here, I'm gonna do it. That's it. I'm not gonna touch any of these little moles. That's her, and that's completely fine. Now I want to bring some more light into the picture, something like sunshine, and I'm gonna do that by creating a new layer. Alright, and I'm gonna rename this layer to sunshine. I want to make a gradient, a radial gradient on this layer. And first I'm gonna use the gradient tool and pick the color, some nice orange warm reddish color like this, and I'm just gonna draw one line from the right side to the left side to create the gradient and simulate the sunshine. So don't get scared that the picture looks like this now. That's just because the layer is in its normal mode. And once I change the mode to soft light, it's gonna look completely different. So I'm gonna click here and change the layer mode to soft light. Now we see our picture again, but it's kind of too orange, and that's completely fine. I can fix that later. What I want to do now is to play a little bit with this gradient tool and make the gradient that I really like. So let's see, I can even start outside of the picture. I think I like this more. And since the picture is still really orange, I'm just gonna go up here to the opacity and decrease the opacity of this layer to something like this. I'm happy with the result now. When I zoom out, turn off the layer, turn it on, you can see how picture looks warmer. The only thing that's left now, and this is really not necessary, is to whiten her teeth a little bit. We added all this orange and now her teeth look kind of yellowish. This is really not a big deal, but I'm gonna show you how to do it since I'm here. So I'm gonna create a new layer and I'm gonna change its mode to saturation to desaturate the teeth. I'm taking a regular brush, and in this case I want to use white or black to desaturate this yellow and make the teeth look kind of gray. So I'm just gonna paint over the teeth, and I'm gonna try to avoid the gums and other areas. I'm gonna decrease the size of the brush a little bit to go over lower teeth. Okay, that's good. I'm not gonna paint over this tooth over here, that's not important. Now her teeth look really, really gray, and I don't want that, of course. So I'm gonna decrease the opacity of this layer to bring a little bit of the color, because no one really has totally gray or white teeth. I'm gonna copy this layer and I'm gonna change the mode for this new layer to soft light. And since we used white paint to paint over her teeth in the saturation layer, and right now I added some white light to her teeth, they look really bright and white. Sometimes you have to zoom out and take a look at the picture, because if you're looking from the close distance, I mean, you zoom too much, then you can be deceived by the colors and you can think that teeth look okay, but if you zoom out you can see sometimes that they look too bright. I'm adding a little bit more sunshine by increasing the opacity of the sunshine layer, and the picture now looks really warm and nice. Now let's compare this with the original version. I'm just gonna select all these layers that we changed, that we're playing with, and I'm gonna go here to layer menu and click merge layers. This is our final layer, and I'm gonna switch it off to see the original image. This is where we started. So again, these are just basic adjustments. We could play with this image more, especially if the image was in the raw format, but I'm not gonna do that now, because the goal of this tutorial was just to improve the picture a little bit and show you guys how from the image without much color, taken on a semi-cloudy day in a late afternoon, you can make a really nice and warm image full of light without using any really advanced filters. I hope you liked the video, and if you did, please subscribe. I'm gonna make more videos like this. I really enjoy helping photographers, and if you have a picture and you want to see how I would edit it, send it to me and I'll do my best to find time to make a video on it. Again, my name is Ivan, my alias is Dreamframer, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.